Well, he is Australia's favourite vet, and Dr. Chris Brown has a brand new project that will make you fall head over paws in love with dogs looking for a forever home. It's called the Doghouse Australia.
Dogs can make a massive difference in people's lives. No matter how bad your day is, you're going to have a good day if you have a dog.
On Sydney's western fringe is a picturesque doggy sanctuary where people come in search of a soulmate. Here, dedicated animal champions rescue the orphaned and abandoned and work tirelessly towards making the perfect love match.
I'm nervous.
Oh my God. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. She's here.
Oh my God, coming, running.
Dr. Chris Brown joins us now. Chris, it's good to see you. You've never been in the doghouse before, have you?
Wouldn't even know what it looks like. Absolutely. Nor would anyone on this show. We're just, and you know, soulmates. Who doesn't have one, right?
Oh,
absolutely.
We need this. We need this right now. The Doghouse Australia. It's been described as a doggy matchmaker show, and you narrate it. How would you describe it?
Yeah, look, I think it's, you've got to be careful in the use of the word matchmaker, because then OSHA is actually legally obliged to host the show. So it's a quest for love, but it's in a different way, because we essentially take these rescue dogs that have often never really had love in their life, and they're essentially in charge of this. They get paired off with families or for people who are looking for a dog. But they may not realise they're looking for this kind of dog, or a dog that that is exactly this type, because quite, you know, as we often know, people in their mind, they judge on appearance. They want a dog that looks or is a certain breed. Well, the dogs don't play by those rules, and they will decide whether you're the perfect home for them based purely around the energy, the vibrancy, and the connection. And I think it's a great metaphor for the fact that, you know, looks don't really count. It is actually, it's all about substance and it's all about personality.
Oh, that's great. Yeah, there's loads of things to consider when getting a new family member, I guess. You touched on there what makes a dog and a family well-suited. Is there a stigma with these rescue dogs that's very different?
Yeah, I think so. I think we sometimes judge rescue dogs a little unfairly, that they've often found themselves needing a home through no fault of their own. It might be a financial reason, or maybe that their owners could have passed away or moved overseas or moved interstate. These aren't bad dogs. They've just had bad luck. And I think that's the important thing to remember. And there's so much stigma around dogs that might be big or bulky or might be of a certain breed background. It doesn't mean they're bad dogs. It just means that they need a fresh start.
Dr. Chris, lots of people got dogs during lockdown. Do you have any tips for people as they head back to work, how to manage that puppy separation anxiety and some of the loneliness that comes with their owners going back to work?
Yeah, I do worry that our next wave, if you like, is almost a wave of dog separation anxiety when we do all eventually return to an office. So my best advice is to appreciate the fact that this has probably been the best 18 months of your dog's life. He'll never get any better. You know, all the trips to the park, all the walking has suddenly... We've started to live our lives like dogs, you know. Our two great joys in our day are going to the park and the arrival of the postman with our online shopping purchases. I mean, we're living a dog's life. So we need to kind of break our way out of that. And my best advice is that for dogs at home right now, for 1 hour a day, when they go looking for your attention or your affection, don't give it to them. And this is tough love, but just make them realise they can't always have your attention and your time on tap. They have to come up with their own life skills and be comfortable in their own space and in their own company and find things that amuse them without being so reliant on you. So just 1 hour a day, just leave them to their own devices and that'll help them to develop those skills.
I think that's great, yeah.
It's kind of mean. Isn't it mean? turning you back on Fido. Dr. Chris is making me do this. I'm not supposed to talk to you.
We have to do the same thing with Sarah Harris around Channel 10 quite often as well. Just 1 hour a day. Just ignore Sarah.
Completely ignores me. New idea's going to get a hold of that.
I love the concept of this show, and a lot of people, they don't know what they're missing until they see it.
Oh, I know.
What about those people who are at home and they're looking to adopt a dog? What kinds of things should they keep an eye out for?
Yeah, I think probably just be open. Have an open mind. Don't have a breed or a certain look in mind. And be fairly brutal in your assessment of yourself. Do you genuinely have the time for a dog? How much exercise are you willing to do each day? Are you looking for a dog that is emotionally needy, that wants your contact the whole time? Or do you want a dog that's a bit more independent? Just really, really decide on what you want. Bring all those qualities together. Talk to someone at a shelter, and they will all, in all chances, have a dog that really suits that criteria. And then, when you eventually meet that dog, have an open mind. Don't judge them on looks. That can be a very dangerous thing in the human world and also the animal world. And then meet them. And if there's a connection, great. But just be patient. Realize that you may not find a dog within a couple of hours. It could be weeks, it could be months, but the right match is out there somewhere.
Aww.
Sorry, I've got one more question. recently, you revealed in an article you wrote for Stellar that you put a dog on Viagra. Mm. What did you want? Please explain.
A tip from the dog, to be honest. But so Viagra, not a lot of people know this. Viagra was originally a blood pressure medication. It just had other, shall we say, benefits. And and so in the vet world, we actually use Viagra for its original use. So for dogs that have a heart condition that leads to a buildup of pressure in the lungs and fluid then in the lungs, you put them on Viagra and that mysteriously clears up. And so it's a very useful drug. Creates a few hassles at the pharmacy when you're queuing up and they say your script for your dog's Viagra is ready with a little wink. Look, I'm happy to provide those awkward moments in the community wherever I can.
Dr. Alaboy.
I can just imagine going up to the pharmacy and going, no, it's for my dog. And I know, honey, they all are. The Doghouse Australia premieres tonight at 7:30 on 10 and 10 Play On Demand. Dr. Chris Brown, we love chatting to you. Can't wait to see your ukulele next time.
It's somewhere, I've hidden away in a back room that could not be seen, trust me.
It's still time, so still many weeks left of 2021, my friend. Might get you on for a Christmas carol.
Counting down the days.
Take care.